pH is not only important for your plants, but also for your fish and the bacteria in your biofilter. Now, in most cases, fish will be alright with a little bit higher pH, say a pH of 8, 8.2, and your fish will still be happy. This is also the same for your nitrifying bacteria. The problem is that your plants will not like a high pH and will prefer a pH of around 6. If your pH is too high, your plants will not be able to take up the necessary nutrients in order for them to perform at an optimum level. Although I do not recommend it, some producers will use acid to lower their pH. One of the acids that they use is citric acid. Now, citric acid's got an antibacterial property and it will damage the bacteria in your biofilter. Another commonly used acid is vinegar. Vinegar is a very weak acid and you don't want to end up with pickled fish. Acids that can be used is phosphoric and nitric acid. You can also use pH down, which is commercially available. These acids can in the short term help you to reduce or to bring the pH down a little bit. The thing is, you must find the problem of the high pH in your system. Now, there's two problems. The first problem is in your grow media. When you've got grow media that's not neutral in your system, you will find that your pH will slowly rise. When you bring it down with acids, it will rise again. The answer for this is to test your grow media. Now, there's a very simple vinegar test that I will do in a different video that where you can easily see when there's a problem with your grow media. The best is before you start to put in grow media in your grow beds, make sure that your grow media is neutral. In most new aquaponic systems, you will find that the pH is a little bit high. But you will also see over time the pH will come down. Now, this is because of the nitrifying bacteria that's producing nitric acid in your biofilter. And in many cases, over time, in a matured aquaponic system, you will find that you need to raise the pH again. The second reason why you may have high pH in your system is the replacement water that you use. If you use replacement water with a high KH value, then you will also find that it will influence the pH of your system to be higher. So the best is to make sure you can get a test kit, test the water, your replacement water, and make sure that the KH value of that water is not too high. A good carbonate hardness value, KH value, will be a value of around 4. If it's lower than 4, then your system will be prone to pH swings. And those swings are not good for the fish in your system. So if your system suffers of a high pH, check your grow media and also check the KH value of your replacement water. If you must change the pH or lower the pH in your system, make sure that you do it slowly because your fish will not like a fast change in pH. On your screen right now, you will see another video that may help you in your journey. Please give a thumbs up and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you and bye-bye.